As you can see, it places that there are no borders, and that we can have a global worldwide communication, and that new generations of scientists are pretty interested. So there are common joint interests and interests from the different countries throughout the different geographies. The objectives of the series is to provide opportunities to future scientists so they can all improve and they can explore education areas that are not normally available at the academic institutions where they go to. And especially when it comes to leadership skills building or organization and resource management. For instance, yesterday I was having an interesting conversation with the organizing committee in the August test there. This opportunity into practice, and some of the components in this slide came about during our conversation, and it was good because it gave me the chance to reflect on how much they have learned throughout the process. Another objective is to provide the students and the future scientists with the opportunity to have a broader perspective of their career to the future. We were also talking about how important it is to have advice from the public and the private sector. We were having this conversation yesterday, and it's not only having representatives of our company, but representatives from the whole private sector. So the students clearly understand their career aspirations and how the landscape will work for them. As you know, this event is entirely organized by students, which will provide them with a general context, with resources, and with horizontal learning opportunities with other students throughout the world. But they were in charge of the organization of the event, and we provide them with a freedom as possible so they don't feel pressured. Anywhere whatsoever. Students worldwide, we have already reached 120 symposia in the last 11 years, so they've got two districts before that, the purpose, and they offer them over budget, they get additional support, and they can see the one that is provided to them by us. They are in charge of the agendas, the different topics, they choose the speakers, they are also in charge of the website. And they also are in charge of the infrastructure, so we can also have the symposia in video conference. We also have a poster contest. We will have this this afternoon. And the students is also encouraged. So these events are not only aimed at more universities, but aimed at different universities. In this case, due to the origin and the nature of this event with CIMIC and the fact that CIMIC is an operative from university, we took advantage of that and we leveraged that so we could have faculty students at different cities with regards to the topic. To the different topics. We started at mainly in terms of improvement. This was a cloud made up by the keywords that will be used in the keywords that have been used throughout the past 11 years in our symposia. We have some respect for improvement, but there are other topics within this series, such as environmental sustainability, agriculture, at a broader level, statistics, Action Committee and their findings, among others. We do believe and we will continue to monitor those charter changes and know that it will evolve over the years and further topics will be incorporated, including the things related to social aspects of the technology and the environment. That is something we also want to encourage with this series, which is a global forum, that has the participation of different institutions as well as throughout the continent of the world. This is a depiction of the different connections created by the speakers in the last 11 years. And as you can see, we have speakers from different continents that have traveled over the world. And if we zoom in a few continents, they'll actually see that those connections are even stronger. But we didn't want to encourage building international connections as for people to know that the world has to be borderless. And anywhere you are, you will have to meet certain goals and shared desires in order to create the global forum. There is something else I wanted to emphasize on. The speakers that are here with us today and how we will reassess having balance between the public and public sector, as you can see. This is a pie chart of the percentages of people from different sectors. Academia, of course, is a big contributor. The non-academic sector as well. I will provide it with a great deal of speakers. I also wanted to mention that this is not only for our company, but from our company that we want to encourage the participation of people from other companies and participants from everywhere. We want to have an open forum where everybody has a say. We do have centralized websites. Each one of our events has its own website, but we do have a centralized website, which is a convention of the different events. And as you can see, you can drop in, or you can browse the main page, and from there you can go to the website of other events throughout the year. And let me say that today, September 6th, we're having four events within different series. One is an Acres Lab, I can tell you that's who it's the Acres Lab Science Symposium. At least, I think they're ending the one because we're also having a two-day event. They started out in September 6th, but they're on a different time zone. We have your event and your event in the U.S. We're in Kansas, and we have another one in Illinois. We will count how many participants we have, both off and online participants, because there are many records and participation records in this year. So if we do, if we get that record, we will celebrate with you. I also wanted to say something, and I don't know if you know, that there's a new platform, CGIAR has a new platform called Excellence in Breeding. It's the Excellence in Breeding platform. Erin worked hard in this platform, and I would just like to make a remark that we have an institutional commitment, institutional dedication, because Kurt Taylor decided to provide structured educational support to the platform. We are proud of doing so, and we do believe that it will provide change and renewal opportunities throughout the system, and more specifically, the international improvement program. So, finally, thank you very much. Thank you for having me. Thank you for joining us. I hope you enjoy the symposium. Enjoy your stay. Enjoy your visit. If you have any questions, please, I'm here for you. Thank you very much.
To continue for the presentation, we welcome the director of the research council, Marianne Massinger, and the presentation of Dr. Massinger, the manager of the Secretary. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Summit. I wanted to know from you, how many of you was your first time at Summit? Many of you already have been here to the before. Okay, maybe half and half. So it is my pleasure that you can organize the second Blind Brain Symposium in Mexico at the end of the clinic. Thank you very much to the organizers, to Cordova, Mr. Pelle, for that support and the cooperation. I want to briefly explain what Summit is. I'm very interested to assist you in this. The Summit mission is to sustainably increase the productivity of families and regionality, guarantee the global food supply, and reducing poverty. As you know, Summit has a lot of concerns. We have put Mason Week, and we are also concerned that one of the largest programs in the world on mass reading and good reading. We are maybe 5 or 6% of Cordova, and we are not really very quick. From 50% of the areas of Mason Week in the developing world, the project with the Chancellor and the Summit, we have projects in Asia, Africa, Latin America, and the United States, Minnesota, for the improvement of the economy, and the socio-economic development. For the Summit, we work from 200 scientists with 55 different nationalities, and many of them work together with the students from the Mexican universities and universities from all over the world. And the targets of the world are challenging. In the coming 30 years, the world needs to produce 50% more food. Production needs to increase, even though it's a climate change change. Even though the diesel production in some countries, and even though that we don't have, considering the fact that there is no more land for agriculture, the prices of water, fertilizers, energy, and labor will increase, as well as the price of the milk and food. And the president of the government of the Green New Deal, people who live with more than $3 a day for food, it is very difficult to get a package and increase the price to sell food. So many of the solutions can come from agricultural research, including the genetic breeding program. And simultaneously, we not only have to produce more, but also more nutritious meals of food and high quality varieties adapted to the biotic and aerobic stresses. Who of you knows that the Norman Bowler? Who knows who that the Norman Bowler is? That's what Norman Bowler used to work in the clinic here after receiving a Nobel Prize for his work. His research and work has begun the Green Revolution here in Latin America and Africa between 1960 and 1970. It is thought that when these people lead today thanks to the work made by the Cabello and police research at Trinidad from New Mexico, that perhaps here at the symposium, not you, we may also have a new environment moment, a person who will change the future thanks to the future you will develop. And agricultural research, if it is possible, we only need to imagine and walk along this direction. So, with this word, I want to welcome you again to Phoenix, and I hope that you have a very fruitful compassion. Thank you. Before, thank you very much. I have some announcements. In this moment, we have limited food and products we have today in this moment. And also to remind you that at 10 past 11, when we will have our coffee break, we will have a group picture session. This is very taken. I ask you to be very brief to do that very quickly because we, on the construction equipment, you need to take them and put them back as you no longer use them. It is my pleasure, so far, to present Dr. Amaya Santa Cruz Varela, who will present the genetic breeding in agriculture presentation. She is a professor for California Law College. And I'm director of the Santa Cruz participated in one of the most important projects worldwide on the molecular characterization of the 59 foundations as many. And so we welcome him. Thank you very much to the organizing committee of this symposium for inviting me. I was asked to develop a subject that I found very good, genetic breeding in agriculture. And I love that because I have the freedom to speak of practically what I started. So I decided to do a compilation of the facts that I find most relevant that have an important incidence on the evolution of genetic breeding. I'm a little bit scared of your friends because of them. For my presentation, I will need some of the presentations, so in some slides I will go very quickly, and in some others I may extend a little bit more than what is expected, but that is the main reason for that. So I will review some historical events, the work of Mendel, the great attainments of the 20th century, what we have covered in the 21st century, the new advances, and the future of this area in the 21st century. To reach a real app of the job that we currently have at this site, it's been necessary to go through different stages that sometimes we consider they might be so obvious that they were needed in order to reach the world real app. Genetics has been a science with a very long childhood. Even below class, there are no philosophers pointing out some knowledge of genetics. I compiled a series of quotations. Socrates used to say in the before Christ, who would say that by his own man like Christ, that given that this man had lazy and they are good for nothing, how can God have just given for his son? But that explanation is not dramatic in nature, but astrological in nature. In the year 1000 before Christ, the Babylon in Babylonia, they brought the sacrifice of pollination in public in order to increase the production of those. And the purpose is used to say the man conveys a hereditary in the sinner. And he did was the truth, so then I see a matter of truth, and then I get more or less equal. Has supplied that it is not the fluid, but it is just more rather the art of the effort. However, and that provides a little bit more of them, we can see with the modern inheritance. Aristotle suggested that the inheritance had grandfathered from the say that the human is constituted by perfectly mixed ingredients, and then he said that children are. And then we get through the interference of the blood of the mother. We cannot say that now today with the gender equality. Otherwise, we will be here building on political intervention. There were some ideas out of the reality that the children can know it from the genetic perspective and all of this. So definitely, diseases, it is accepted that some diseases are here at the level of the family. They would say men cannot stay the role to them, that in their genetics. Then, in 1809, Lamarck presented his theory of the acquired characters. As they continue here, we develop the size of any organ while not using it, makes it weak until it disappears with a typical example of the long neck of giraffes in the savannah. So the plant would be higher, so they may have to grow. And then the one took a statement according to him to discover new animals in the stamina fluid. And even in the 19th century, it was talked about an amontillis, that is to say, a little bank inside another one, and still containing all the common generations. It was in the 19th century, not very far away from now, and we still have this idea. Then, in 1859, Charles Darwin published the so-called book that continues to force up to the state the origin of species based on natural selection. This is a bestseller, and when it put out of this book and they are quickly sold, it is difficult to find original or a copy of them in the bookstore. The most prominent example of evolution would be that men come from apes. And somebody added one more step in evolution, and they would say, well, that is the direction we are heading to with a modern diet with all this junk food and all of that. Another step in evolution. Perhaps the fundamental work of genetics in the 19th century was thanks to Mendel. A little bit of history of Mendel, who came from Austria. He was he entered the monastery of Brunn, then he studied mathematics and mechanics in the University from 1850 to 1853, then he went back to the monastery, and there he conducted a work that he started composing in our genetics courses. He made some mistakes in the garden, 7 by 34 35 meters. He had a crop of 20,000 plants of 34 different varieties. He was a non-vegetarian trees, but he also worked with some fruit trees, and he obtained some 12,000 descendants obtained from crossings, he controlled crosses, and kept some 300,000 fruits, which were established at the Congress of the interpretation of natural history that went from February 8 to March of the 8th. And in the past, they were longer than the end of this Monday and Congress at the National Association of Private Genetics, and you are invited to collaborate with the virus. And his conclusions would not generate interest among the audience constituted mainly by astronomers, botanists, and mathematicians. And this is one of his original manuscripts. There was no interest from that part, and his work is so complicated that genetics continued to progress. Since 1883, there is a researcher that will work observed that before the stellar division, there was some slender threads that correlated in the theoretical factors, and they duplicate and they disappear. Now, we can fully explain this situation. At that time, they were called chromosomes. And then, it was found that the nuclear division involved the end of one of the division of those chromosomes and the migration of children of the nuclear, and this was known as the mitosis. Then, the 20th century is fundamental for genetics and for the improvement of breeding, and it starts with the great discovery of Mendel's law. Who discovered them? It was Carl Collins, who was a degree and a long fragment. And they found out that the chromosomes, they were known by the end of the 19th century, that they perform as the genes do. They keep their identity in hybrids and separate cells separate, irrespectively, when the antenna cells are produced. This discovery constitutes the connection of Mendel's findings. Please remember that every couple of genes have a couple of alleles. And if we put that in perspective, it was practically the same. Mendel noted that the level of an individual gene. But when we have a chromosome is an association of genes, and it was postulated later by Thomas Mankiewicz, who is the chromosomic theory. So those chromosomes, divided in meiosis, and they separate along the chromosome. And they also got the applicable chromosome, and the computer would be applicable at the level of an individual gene. And that was the connection. That chromosomes have been already observed through the microscope, and then the monomers were aspect monomers. What else happened in the 20th century? At the beginning, there was a formulation of the Hardy-Weinberg output balance that relates the genetic frequencies with the genotypic frequencies in the genetic populations. And for things such as genetic improvement, there were the ideas of Sherman East. And this was fundamental later on for the formation of hybrids. These are the basics, and it was said that the biology of fruit pollination in maize would compose a series of heterogeneous phenotypes in wheat, which can develop secure and heterogeneous lines. Staff are breeding within 5 to 7 generations, which produce some organic breeding lines, and they were homogeneous at wheat. However, when those were wheat lines were intercrossed, the final ones were over, and the breeding of the cross generally exceeded that of the original variety where the lines came from. And we just stayed there for a couple of days, and it was by the end of the 20s. And then I think that this was Henry Wallace commercially applied those ideas of fresh fruit, the ministry of the pioneer in saving hybrid fruit. And he started at Iowa State University, and he founded the company Pioneer, with the surprise of now it is called Coterra. And it was Thank you. with this, it was proven that it is not so, and the other components of DNA. And it was found that they had a structural role to keep and persist in the process, and now we know that it is all the way around. And the chromosomes are kept on and they are there to provide a background to the DNA. So the history of DNA is actually actually discovered that the DNA is the genetic material. It was discovered in the 1940s by this researcher, but the structure was established by Watson and Crick. Also, they also went to Franklin to get participation there and Mr. Wilkins in England. This is perhaps the most famous article I can ever see because it's done for you. This is the original document that makes the publication. One decade after, one of the siblings of the genetic code by Mr. Marshall Nuremberg and Heinrich Salmattei after the work of Watson and Crick. With that, they wrote about the genetic code was detected, and they learned for the ideas that now seems to have common, but it was not so in the past. This experiment was very complex. They demanded a lot of work to finally reach the genetic profiling. And in the 1970s, Francis Crick produced or proposed the Central Dogma of Molecular Biology. And it was believed that the genetic information flows from DNA to the process of transcription. It is the synthesized and messenger RNA that leads the message of the DNA to the cytoplasm, where these characteristics are those of the ribosomes, and then the regular applying the genetic code to produce a protein which is the genotype. From this moment, genetics, the geneticist at that time, thought that everything was discovered. And they would say, well, we know everything, we know what is the DNA structure, we know how the message is coded, we have the genetic code, where the mRNAs are produced, and they are written triplets, and every one of them represents a amino acid and proteins and so on according to the order of the messages of the messenger RNA. So genetics reached its maturity. And there was nothing else to discover. But it was a total mistake because it was thought that the genetic was mature in the 1960s and 1970s. And they thought that they knew everything. But, well, we have still medical prizes to find in the 1960s. The molecular markers began at first through proteins, and this is some signs here in Pokemon, and it looks like the idols and it's made, and it was in the 1960s. And in the 80s, they began with the DNA markers, first with the RFPs that are represented here in red. And this is the use frequency again through the years, and now observed that there were some of them that sort of returned, they left, and they provided the 90s, that the market satellites began somewhere around the 90s, and they had the kingdom early in the 21st century, but we can see the shift attempt for the future, and still the years, but now the frequency is reduced. This is the frequency of transcribes of the biochemical markers, and this will have a percent practically, and now they appear to disappear because there are two markers that are easy to define, but they have now the disadvantages. We will see this many fiber brain. And this is the answer, which is to any other protein. But we can see a trend over here. And the sequencing methods are taking the front, not
more sequence to know, like if we look at this, the sequencing page for a peptide. So it's exponential, it's grown exponentially from 2013 to 2014. So what is happening? There is optimism, you know, because what has to be ended today is the optimism, you know. Now, let me give you an example of what that means. Perhaps my body has a certain taste, but I'm fighting those new tastes with my clothes and you know, what is that all about? You know, I'm going to be attracted because of my feet, because of my shirt. You don't know anything about the original information underneath it all. It's pretty favorable to putting content. And there are two important phenomena for every country. Haptonexus is an epigenetic phenomenon. Haptonexus is a pretty slippery nature, you know. Haptonexus plants have been combined to non-haptonexus plants, and we all of a sudden have a future one. So we are just at the two level, like you may think that it's an individual gene, but when we reach the genetic sequencing, that gene has never been found. But we suspect that this is an epigenetic phenomenon. What's important here is that the epigenome is indeed determined by the environment. It depends on our life history. It is said that phenotypically obese persons tend to have obese children. So phenotypically, our lifestyle depends on our inheritance in certain ways. The project currently underway that studies the epigenetics on how Brazil's earthquake had an impact on the people who went through that level of stress. There is the evening developed by the Mexico City Economic Institute. So, imagine that. So, it turns out that Lamarck was right. Lamarck was thought as having made a mistake when he talked about acquired traits. Acquired or inherited traits. But, yeah, I think he was right because epigenetics are those acquired traits that are inherited. So, is there a prevalence? Well, we don't know that yet because the epigenome, we are trying to find out for how many generations it will be inherited and what about the intensity. So, it is also an open path for genetic improvement. And we also have to talk about genomic editing because it is a way of improving the DNA to change the sequence. And it's something that will be done by designing the RNA so we can sound kind of the sequence we want. We add on an enzyme called 9+9. It's the DNA sequence that we want to modify. And that's it. We're breaking into the cell that triggers a repair mechanism. And when that double chain breaks, this is the double chain. So when it breaks, due to whatever mechanism, whatever you want, a repair mechanism is triggered. It is an enzyme. It disrupts a part of the chain of one chain, not the other, so the other two legs of the chain can get together. But this disruption of DNA tries to have micromorphism between the other two chains so they can get together. So it means that there is a path lost in DNA, and that path is for the interesting, we will cause an increasing. That mutation will lead us to gene silencing, which is what we see here. Repair takes place, but it's not a perfect repair. A DNA fragment is lost, and there is genetic silence. There's yet another outcome. In addition to the restriction enzyme, the DNA removal then stated with a red sequence that we want to add it to that prompt. So, the broken, and that plant or the organ isn't broken. Recombination holds homologous recombination type mechanism. And when that happens, when the double chain is torn apart, this chain is disrupted as well as broken. The DNA segment is lost. However, the molded segment that we inserted is now considered as a right combination. So the disruption takes place nonetheless. One segment of the other father is copied. This is why in recombination, when the committed material is exchanged, but it's not a new material, it's a new synthesis, but the mold is the other father, the other parent. So the mold is a right to be inserted, and that's when we all know that we have changed, that we have modified the genetic information. This is extremely powerful because we can take it to whatever sphere we may want. And it covers as made other things possible as well. It has nine, and let's talk about Cas13, because this is also everything that's got RNA level. Cas13 takes place at RNA level to carry out those transcription modifications at RNA messenger level. This area has many other applications of those. I don't have time to talk about them all. How it got this from the last set of math and blue speaker. They said, we took the DNA, we opened it up, we created a gene, we just sewed it, it was an invisible region. So this becomes part of the DNA, and it stays there for the rest of their life. And you know, this is like, super important. So it's like pyramid, you know, it's like going with every cell. That's what it is in practical terms. There are many applications, but there are yet at experimental level. This is another example where applications in medicine. I'm here to talk about agriculture, so I'm not going to talk about it. And you know, there's always controversy. If you initially want more to become a scientific, to have a scientific expert, that's, you know, the declaration for society, the protocol for environmental, you're doing a classic with all the genomic sequencing, it's a mess, and it could be on. I do really find the locals who are looking for, but who will guarantee that it will not find another insight with that relatively small sequence? And there are studies from the University of Iowa, not Iowa State, but Iowa, in Iowa City. They reconstructed the sequence after the CRISPR modification, and they were able to find hundreds of modifications to that original sequence. So, for the future, replacement of replacing food banks by green banks. You know, now we're going to have, instead of having warehouses where foods end up going, what about having green banks where the motors of banks you can hold around the time and space for the expression? They also have genetic drivers that are still pending, and same hypothetical biology, you know, that they are more damaging to 30 cells. Take a look at this. This is the net outcome, the net yield of genetic improvement. This is ongoing yield in the United States. As some hybrid introduction, as retention went up, and there's no way to deny it. Nonetheless, a few things we can do on these scores. John Duke. One group was my teacher at Iowa State, and along the way, we were getting so considered a model for research. They gave a talk, and he talked about it. And he said, Peter Rose has offered to remain here without removing everything that we started. It's the same we have here and there. however, years to meet. Yeah. Well, because the buildings continue to improve your pipelines are creating higher performance. And this year is due to recurring reciprocal selection of base top relations with the different components of the aerobic body. But it's due to recurring reciprocal selection. We must not taking the selection aside. All dialogue traditionally used with the hand target is always recurring selection. These are the outcomes of the genetic improvement in Mexico. These are the irrigation zones when we're about to reach the 10 per hectare average they have in the United States, but it's feasible. In this case, a change is more modest than that because it's a different type of a change selection. This is what it's amazing. Finally, I found this energy source. Agriculture is the lifeline of this question. It is an education center crisis and a best path for teens and men. But we congratulate the students who chose genetic improvement as their area and their lifestyle. It is true that genetic improvement is indeed the best action. And it took by a long time ever since agriculture began. Perhaps medicine may be a fair competitor, but today's society remains thanks to genetic improvement. It needs to be aligned to with our society. 70% of Mexican farmers have nothing. Got technical advisory, but those honors not intended, but it do take place in restricted areas because most Mexican farmers are still awaiting your collaboration to take advantage. Are there any questions about this presentation? Dr. Stefan. Hello. It's not a question necessarily about the presentation because I understand that you were part of. So we're talking about genetic improvement. I would like to know if that means you have any type of improvement potential because we know that breeders and improvers are reluctant to use this type of medicine. So that's my question. Is there any potential for this type of medicine? Well, there is a huge potential because this means commonly higher than hybrid, many of the land bases. And it's not that they don't work, but it's because hybrids are generally developed in different conditions. And they are develop better conditions and different conditions to those that they were developed for. So what needs to be done is to change in breeding and improvement techniques on site because the seasonality is also a reality that we need to leverage their superiority as to use the things to well match or work in other places that they need to come to. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Amaya. number of books that are in the Mexican country devoted to innovation, development, research, agricultural processes in Mexico, bioprotecting, plague, disease, and problems at an early stage. This presentation is by Michael Herrera, engineer from the Netherlands University, and we also hold a business master's degree from the University of Iowa in Madrid. He carries the investigation in research and UADD, as well as design and optimization of ways. In addition to testing the mechanical aspects of aluminum alloys to aerospace applications, thermodynamics, and structural modeling for the aerospace industry. Let us welcome him on his presentation on high performance technology. Good morning, everybody. I think that I sort of put everybody with further information about my resume, which is a little bit more in a round. I want to thank the postgraduate college and everybody who was engaged in having this event. It is an honor for me to share what we have done in partnership with the government, private institutions, and non-profit organizations. A company is specifically devoted to provide high-value information with review relevance and developing any type of tech. The content of my presentation is the challenge ahead of us. It is the tools available to tackle the challenges ahead, and how information can be applied in the field with high precision agriculture, as well as tangible benefits of newer technologies that have an impact on agriculture at the global level. I think we all know what the challenge is. The challenge is to teach the 9 billion people. We no longer need to be official. The year for 2018 is $10 billion by 2050. But there are additional issues. How will agriculture become sustainable? Sustainable activity that will help us deal and cope with climate change. That is agriculture in our daily lives. This presentation has to do with another presentation from the people from China. We have reactions. Option number one is the last job to cut power with the reason that struggles focus on a photonic. 54% of the land that is not covered with water is devoted to food production. So what type of changes are implied in deforestation of some land? The second option is to colonize other planets. A sort of Venus that goes to Mars, or to run as Jupiter's moons, and we start working with NASA's experiments on Earth life. But the third option is to make efficient use of currently available resources. I mean, natural resources, human resources. So that's the time we face to go to market. So the time to get technology, information technology. How are we going to manage soil and water resources? How are we going to dynamically adapt to climate change? And how is it that we will not resist carries by the different variables when it comes to crop development? So that's a huge challenge we have ahead of us, and that challenge is to create something that's flexible and is smart, that will provide us with a say, a screenshot of what specialized to tell us exactly the number of non-violent mandatory practicing question and application. Thank you.
say, if we can get it to 34% and back it to 55%. And we know what happens to the education. And the same way, some of it is that we need to have a specific rent to or letters of our home, the maybe two of our electric connectivity, so that if that one's there for our home, the tienes beneficio de tus tecnologías de avalanche, que no haga los problemas de tu reformación con el ángel, ya que con el sentido de que no eres de la vida, que te da a ti, de cuanto le plantea, en que el cliente puede recorrer tan cantidad de prayers that would not allow this time to do great harm to those healed, thank you for the contribution of the man of God. For the Bible says that it's taken in a similar way, where it is depicted in different colors, we are depicting the different basics. And in the Bible, we can do that differently through our map. We can use the landscapers. This is especially interesting when we have preservation of agriculture, but the point that we have is the culture of roots. So the technology we use is that we have the landscapers that depicts the plant and diet is in the task that we have done with our farmers, every time I just say that up to 80% of the people when they do the application of herbicide. So of course, we need to use a different type of technology like this one. And this is what is being used in Australia. All the more recent technologies we have available with plastic plants that will allow our very personalized applications to the field. And I'm sure that I can answer for you if you wish it. But, I want to tell you that there is a restriction in terms of the plants that are used for application of some products that we need to use in localized way. That is not the fact. They are not good for the place where they are going to order spray machines. Well, it's good for us, and we can have an example of bioavailability reason, which implies even the proper amount of water needed to be permitted. Fertilizer relation system, it could be the fiber, the planter movement, the sprinklers, the irrigation, etc. And finally, we have a partner that is using mapping, where we use the GPS and the sensors to monitor the network of plants. And so what we want to do with this field of maps, we want to detect the areas with lower tier to identify the reason for that and to make a decision to provide those with faster plants in general. We insist that you have an approach, and I want to share some interesting cases for the first time. Since I can do some of that, in the middle, we can go to A, and we have a CP, and this is a satellite image taken 10 days after the same planting day. The only difference is the penetration. So here we can take the samples that are better than others from our iPhone device. All the cases are quite demonstrated in the use of satellite and drone technology that would provide a possibility to provide. Even they are very sensitive to infrared light and plants are also very tricky when they are exposed. Could also provide us the capacity to see what is happening before we get to that with our eyes. The farmers who can get these yellow spots, the something investigation, so the technician went to the field and they were doing work out of the middle of the year. As far as they talk to the farmers, a change from the orange colors that would indicate more stress, and then would say, oh, something is on the ground there. But well, the technician can even say, no, everything is okay. So he went back, went to the field, and started to do some pictures, and he found he had not noticed that he would lose more than 1 million places in this step. And therefore, the commandment of the other one says, now we need information to be done. And that is the
Now that I'm a year old, it would be great to get a break from them as well. So, if there are no further questions, we want to thank Sheriff Foster for his attendance, for his participation, and coordination with us. Thank you.